One more time, here we go. Hi, I'm Jamie Davis, the Pod Medic, and I'm back here at EMS Today 2013 with another episode of Innovations in Patient Care, brought to you by GEMS, Penwell, and Physio-Control, to talk a little bit more with one of our EMS 10 award winners, or a member of the organization that received the award, Matt Zawadzki.
You rehearsed that well.
I rehearsed it. I practiced a lot. I got all the hard names. Chris Montero got the easy names. And next time, I'm going to divide the names up.
For Chris, it needs to be simple.
It does. It does, actually. Tell us a little bit. You got this this award for the EMS 10 award for MedStar. But tell a little bit about your position and what you do with them and your association with EMS.
Sure. I'm very fortunate to be the Director of Public Affairs for MedStar. I've been their operations director for several years prior to that. But the role is essentially to help guide some innovation and guide actually the entire organization, how we position ourselves with our stakeholders.
And MedStar changed the name recently to change the way that they featured themselves. They're no longer EMS.
In fact, that was one of the reasons why MedStar as an organization was recognized as an EMS 10 innovator, because we did kind of take that bold step to some extent by changing our name from MedStar Emergency Medical Services to MedStar Mobile Healthcare, to more closely align not only really what we do every day, but where we see ourselves in the overall integration of mobile healthcare into the practice of medicine.
So tell us a little bit about how MedStar is integrating that into the, it seems like you've got a community paramedicine model going on.
Well, we started with the sort of traditional community paramedic model, looking at our EMS loyalty program members. Mm-hmm. That may be using EMS and the emergency medical care system for their source of primary health care. But it quickly evolved to much larger than just community paramedicine as our collaborators in the community, the hospitals, the ACOs, the payers, the hospice agencies, learned about the programs that we were doing, came to us with some issues that they were having that they felt we might be able to help them with.
And you identify those individuals and you get them the services they need.
Exactly. So, for example, one of the ways that we've integrated with the mobile healthcare system, or integrated with the healthcare system, is, as you know, many agencies are doing now with the frequent flyers, but also the CHF patients that the hospitals don't want to come back, the hospice patients that are at risk for calling 911 and revoking their hospice status, the patients who might be observationally admitted into the hospital for 23 hours, or in some cases 72 hours observation, and a number of programs to help get patients the right care at the right time, at the right place, right outcome, right cost.
So you're not a system that says if you call, we haul. It's more of a broad definition.
There's always a component of that, because there are always people that are going to crash their cars. There are always people that are going to have mishaps at home. There are always people whose alarms are going to go off and come through on the podcast. But we're still going to have to manage those patients. But we view the 911 call, quite frankly, as a failure on our part to prevent that call. Our goal is to try and prevent people from having to call 911 by bringing in the right resource, which oftentimes is in advance of their particular need to activate the emergency care system.
So actually, utilizing that prevention paragraph we all had in our training, you know, it's interesting. We're supposed to be involved in prevention, but how many of us really go there?
Many of us are not, but hopefully more of us will become more involved, because the current economy, the current changes in healthcare finance, will now finally reward preventing that episodic incident that results in high dollar care when we could have intervened much more effectively, both clinically and economically, earlier in that process.
How about the integration with the hospital facilities in your area? How has that gone for you? Because it seems that the connection for finding the services and connecting with other healthcare is important, and you naming yourselves mobile healthcare now takes us out of that we're always pigeonholed into the public safety sector.
Correct. The MedStar system is designed to be very regional, very collaborative. We serve 15 cities under an interlocal agreement, mm-hmm. Fort Worth being the largest city, but we're also clinically supervised by an emergency physicians advisory board, which is made up of the physician medical directors of all of the emergency rooms that we bring patients to, plus members of the Tarrant County Medical Society. So everybody in the system has ownership in that system. And when you can go to an EPAB board meeting and have folks that are physician level, administration in the hospitals, talking about our paramedics, they say,
wow,
we don't want our paramedics to have to deal with diversion. We don't want our paramedics to have to do X. We would like our paramedics to be empowered to do Y. That is awesome when you've got that much community buy-in, that community stake, that the hospitals and the physician administrators in those hospitals refer to the paramedics as our paramedics. That's awesome.
That's amazing. That really is. I mean, that definitely says that that integration has happened because they've got ownership of the system from top to bottom.
Exactly right. And many of the programs that we are doing now and all of the 350 people that make up our system are doing are because those stakeholders have come to us with, hey, we have this issue on observation patients. We have this issue on hospice patients. We have this issue on CHF patients. Mm-hmm. So it makes it very easy to capitalize on relationships that you've already built in your community when you can demonstrate the value to them and they just keep bringing things that they think would add value to their need. It's awesome.
It really is awesome. And congratulations on doing what you're doing. And,
thank you.
And that. Real quick, before we wrap up, tell me a little bit about what you think about programs like the EMS 10 Awards that are recognizing innovators in EMS on an annual basis and trying to bring out the groups and the organizations and the individuals that are doing really great things.
It is so important for on two levels. One, to really recognize people in front of their peers that have been involved in taking a risk.
Yeah.
Being on the bleeding edge of change, which often means you've got blood on the floor when
yeah.
you've done that.
Yeah.
But also for the whole industry to be able to get a summary every year of, wow, these are the 10 most innovative things that are happening in the industry, and how can I take some of these things, do that in our local community, and that helps the entire profession.
Excellent. Well, I want to thank you again, and congratulations to MedStar Mobile Health for winning the EMS 10 Award and leading the charge for innovative ways we integrate with our entire healthcare system.
Thank you.
I appreciate it.
Thank you for this opportunity.
All right. And I want to thank all of you for checking out another episode of Innovations in Patient Care. We're here again from EMS Today 2013 with our episode. And thanks again to GEMS, to Penwell, and to Physiocontrol for sponsoring this event. I'm Jamie Davis, the PodMedic. I'll be back soon with another episode. In the meantime, remember to stay safe and stay tuned here to Innovations in Patient Care.